Greetings, friends. An interesting new feature called Adaptive Profiles was recently added into the Adobe Lightroom family of products. Before we get started, I need to make two quick points. First, the Adaptive Profiles feature is part of the Adobe Lightroom Classic version 14.2 release. If you have not installed this update yet, then you will not be able to find this new feature. Second, Adaptive Profiles only work with RAW files. If you're working with a JPEG, then you will not be able to utilize this new feature. With those little notes out of the way, let's get started. When we are talking about processing raw images, the profile sets the initial look for your photograph. The profile affects the picture's overall contrast and color saturation. As you can see, if I choose a profile like Adobe Neutral, then I'm asking Lightroom to use a low contrast and low saturation starting point. The opposite is true if I pick a very high contrast, high saturation profile like Adobe Vivid. This is old news for those of you who've been processing raw images for years, but until now, our profile choices have always been applied globally. By global, I mean that the adjustments that the profile makes happen everywhere across your image. If I choose the new Adaptive Color Profile option instead, then something very different happens. This profile changes the brightness and the saturation, but it's using an AI-trained model to target different parts of my image. I can make this even more apparent if I drag the profile slider up or down. For the first time, the changes that a profile creates are dynamic and content-specific. Now, I applaud Adobe's efforts here, but like all things AI, the results that you get when using adaptive profiles will vary from image to image. Now that I've had a few months to beta test this new feature, I think that the new adaptive color profile is a great starting point for landscape images with dark foreground elements and some bright clouds up in the sky. But the thing that I want to emphasize is that adaptive profiles are not meant to be a one-click solution. Like any type of raw profile, adaptive is only meant to be a starting point. After you choose this profile, then it's time to use all of Lightroom's other image processing tools to further polish up your image. On this photo, for example, I would jump right into my usual tone processing steps after applying the new profile. If needed, I would also adjust the white balance at this point. And then I would proceed with all of the other steps in my usual image processing workflow. If adjusting the tone, the color, or the saturation is new for you, then please work your way through my other tutorials after you finish this video. I'm not going to fully polish up this photo right now, but I want to quickly point one more thing out. Although the adaptive profile uses AI, it does this without creating any masks that we can edit. If I open up Lightroom's masking panel at this point, then you can see that there are currently no masks at all inside of this panel, which means that I can add even more drama into the sky, and there's nothing stopping me from following my usual masking workflow. I'm not going to take the time to truly perfect this image, but if I set my screen to the before and after view mode, then you can see what a difference even these quick basic edits have made here. Just so you know, Adobe also included another version of the adaptive profile for black and white conversion. Compare the results that I get here when I try Adobe Monochrome compared to the new adaptive black and white. That's a pretty good starting point. And of course, from here, I'm free to further refine this black and white using all of Lightroom's other tools. Now that you understand what adaptive profiles do, let's talk about some potential pitfalls. First, adaptive profiles raise some order of operations problems. If you add an adaptive profile to your image, and then if you use the remove tool to replace a large portion of your image, you might end up with some weird ghost-like artifacts. The problem that you're seeing here is that the changes to the color and the brightness that the adaptive profile created are not automatically updated when large objects are removed. Fortunately, there are two ways to solve this problem. Option one is to reset things and then to do your large image cleanup before you apply the adaptive profile. If I do things in the opposite order this time, if I do the removal and then apply the profile, there is no problem. There is no problem because the unwanted object wasn't there when the adaptive profile analyzed this image. That order of operations advice is good to know, but there are a lot of times when this advice is not practical. Think about how many images you have where you've already added some edits and where you're eager to try out this new technology without starting all over. If I go back in history and I return to the example where I had applied the profile and then used the remove tool, then I can show you an alternative solution. Lightroom recognizes that I have done things here that might create these ghostly artifacts. So it's added a little red dot, a warning dot here beneath the edit tools icon. And it's also put a red dot up there beside the word basic. If I return to the basic panel at this point, then a new update profile button has magically appeared. Tapping on this button forces Lightroom to recalculate the adaptive profile, and with that, the ghost disappears. The next workflow problem that you might encounter happens when you try to use the auto button at the top of the basic panel plus an adaptive profile. The problem here is that the auto algorithm is not smart by today's standards. So when I try to apply it on top of a raw file that's already using the new adaptive color profile, then things often look very fake or over-edited. Adobe is aware of this potential pitfall, so they've added this additional warning box to caution you against following this sequence of steps. Despite the warning, I'll tap continue just to show you what happens. And they were right. Using auto tone plus the adaptive profile makes this image look totally overprocessed. Fortunately, nothing in Lightroom is set in stone, so I can go edit, undo, and be done with that complete mess. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.